Hello students, under the aegis of Director General Higher Education Haryana for undergraduate classes, myself Dr. Neeru, Assistant Professor in Zoology, Shrimati Aruna Asaf Ali Government BC College Kalka, will discuss with you Type Study of Rat Part 3 today. In this part of video, first of all we will discuss nervous system. Nervous system is divided into three main divisions: central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and autonomic nervous system. Central nervous system is mainly consists of anterior large brain and posterior long and narrow spinal cord, which is dorsal, hollow, and non-ganglionated part of the central nervous system. Next is the peripheral nervous system, which is formed of whitish thread-like nerves, which extend between the central nervous system and different body parts, which are sense organs and muscles. So this peripheral nervous system, it controls the voluntary functions of the body, and it includes two types of nerves, cranial nerves and spinal nerves. Next is the autonomic nervous system, which consists of different fibers which join to spinal nerves and cranial nerves, and they extend up to the visceral organs of the body. And autonomic nervous system mainly controls involuntary functions like heartbeat, peristalsis, etc. And it is formed of mainly sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Now we will discuss the brain. Brain is present inside the cranial cavity of the cranium of the skull, and the brain is covered by the three meninges, which are the membranes around the brain. These are pia mater, arachnoid membrane, and dura mater. Pia mater is the inner thin vascular lining, and arachnoid membrane is the middle lining. It is also thin and vascular, and it is mainly formed of reticular connective tissue. And dura mater is the outer thicker and fibrous membrane present around the brain, and it lies along the inner side of the cranium of the skull. And all the spaces present in the brain are filled with the cerebrospinal fluid, which is alkaline in nature and has a specific gravity of about 1.005. And now the structure of the brain. The brain consists of three parts: forebrain, which is also called as prosencephalon, midbrain, also called as mesencephalon, and hindbrain, which is also called as rumencephalon. Now we will discuss the forebrain. Forebrain is formed of three parts. One is the olfactory lobe, which is also called as rhinencephalon. They are one pair in rat, small sized, solid, and differentiated into two parts, olfactory bulb and olfactory tract. Anterior swollen part is the olfactory bulb and posterior narrow part is the olfactory tract. And what is the function of olfactory lobes? They control the smell. They are small sized in rat because rat is less dependent upon the smell. Next part of the forebrain is the cerebral hemispheres, which are also called as telencephalon. They are larger in size and form the 80% of the weight of the brain. Both the hemispheres together, they are called as cerebrum, and they are demarcated by a fissure, which is called as median or cerebral fissure. Roof of each cerebral lobe is called as pallium, and it is highly folded to form the ridges and depressions, which are called as gyri and sulci. Ventrolateral part of the cerebrum is called as the corpora striata, which is thick. A few deep fissures are present in the cerebral hemisphere, which divide the cerebral hemisphere into four lobes. Each cerebral hemisphere has four lobes due to these fissures, which are called as anterior frontal lobe, middle parietal lobe, posterior occipital lobe, and lateral temporal lobe. And whole the cerebral hemisphere has the fluid-filled cavity in them, which are called as lateral ventricle or paraceal. Two cerebral hemispheres are interconnected by a thick band of transverse nerve fibers, which is called as corpus callosum. Peripheral portion of each cerebral hemisphere is formed of gray matter, which is called as cerebral cortex, and deeper part of the cerebral hemisphere is formed of white matter, which is called as cerebral medulla. Cerebral cortex is the highest center for many sensations and activities. The functions of the cerebral hemispheres are: they control all the voluntary activities of the bodies, they are concerned with the perception of a number of sensory stimuli, they are the seat of the memory and learning. Here in this diagram, you can see the olfactory bulb and olfactory tract and cerebral hemispheres and few other parts of the brain like optic chiasma, optic nerve, hypothalamus and cerebellum. Next part of the forebrain is the diencephalon, which is also called as thalamencephalon. It is formed of thalami, which are the pair of masses of gray matters, that is neurons, and they act as the relay centers. They receive the nerve impulse of the pain, temperature, touch, etc., and conduct them to the cerebral hemisphere. Next part is the hypothalamus, which is formed of one pair of the neurons present in the cerebral medulla below the thalami, and it controls the involuntary functions like hunger, thirst, sweating, sleep, fatigue, water balance, blood pressure, anger, fear, etc. It also acts as the thermostat of the body, means regulate the body temperature. It also secretes the releasing hormones, which are also called as neurohormones, and controls the secretion of various hormones from the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Hypothalamus gives rise to a nervous process which is called as infundibulum, and it meets the non-nervous pharyngeal outgrowth which is called as hypophysis, and both infundibulum and hypophysis are collectively called as pituitary body, which is the site for the secretion of various hormones of the body. In front of the hypothalamus, there is a cross of two optic nerves, which is called as optic chiasma. In this diagram, you can see the olfactory bulb, olfactory tract, there is present optic chiasma, and pituitary stalk, and cerebral peduncles, and various other parts of the brain. Diencephalon contains in it a narrow cavity which is called as third ventricle or diaceal. It is connected with the lateral ventricles of the cerebral hemispheres by foramen of Munro, and it is connected with posteriorly with the fourth ventricle of medulla oblongata through an aperture which is called as iter or aqueduct of Sylvius. Roof of diencephalon is called as epithalamus, and its anterior part of epithalamus forms the anterior choroid plexus, which secretes the cerebrospinal fluid, and posterior part of epithalamus forms the pineal body, which acts as the endocrine gland and secretes the melatonin hormone. Functions of the diencephalon are: it acts as a relay center, it coordinates with the autonomic nervous system, controls the involuntary functions of the body, secretes neurohormones, forms a part of the pituitary gland, It also secretes cerebrospinal fluid and maintains the homeostasis in the body by regulating the body temperature, heartbeat, blood pressure, etc. Now, the second part of the brain, which is called as midbrain or mesencephalon, it mainly consists of two parts, optic lobes and cerebral peduncles. Optic lobes, jo hai, they are one pair, large sized, and they are present on the dorsal side, and they contain in them a cavity which is called as optocoele. And their main function is to control the vision and auditory stimuli. Next is the cerebral peduncles, which are also a pair of thick bands consisting of longitudinal nerve fibers, and they are present on the floor of the midbrain, and their function is to act as the coordination centers between the forebrain and hindbrain. Next is the hindbrain, rhombencephalon, which is formed of three parts. Cerebellum is formed of three lobes, which are two cerebral hemisphere and one is the vermis. Cerebellum is the well-developed part of the brain, and it is also called as little brain. Or cerebral hemispheres, they are one pair, large-sized lobes present on the lateral sides. And vermis is the median lobe, which is present between the two cerebellar hemispheres. Peripheral part of this cerebellum is formed of cerebral cortex, which is the gray matter, and central part is formed of the white matter, which is also called as cerebellar medulla. The white matter of the cerebellum contains the tree-like branching pattern, which are called as arbor vitae. This is the diagram of the brain showing cerebellum and vermis and different type of other parts of the brain. Hindbrain coordinates the voluntary movements of the body, and it also controls the equilibrium and posture of the body. Now, the next part of the brain, it is the posterior most part of the brain, which is called as medulla oblongata or mesencephalon. It is located beneath the cerebellum. It is with a cavity which is called as fourth ventricle or mesencephalon, which is the continuous with the central cavity of the spinal cord. Roof of the medulla oblongata is non-nervous and thin, and it is called as posterior choroid plexus. The main functions of the medulla oblongata is to control the involuntary functions of the body like urination, defecation, blood pressure, swallowing of food, etc. In this diagram, you can see the cerebrum, different olfactory bulb, cerebellum, medulla oblongata, having the fourth ventricle and the spinal cord. Now the pons veruli. These are the thick band of transverse nerve fibers present at the floor of the upper part of the medulla oblongata, and their function is to coordinate the two cerebellar hemispheres. And they connect the medulla with the higher centers of the cerebrum. Now the spinal cord. Spinal cord is a long, soft, whitish, cylindrical rod present in the neural canal of the vertebral column. Its external structure. Externally, it extends from the lower end of the medulla oblongata, and it has two longitudinal grooves or fissures, which are called as deep ventral sulcus and shallow dorsal sulcus. internal structure of spinal cord shows that it has a narrow longitudinal canal, which is called as central canal or neurocoele, which is connected anteriorly with the fourth ventricle of the medulla oblongata, and this canal is closed posteriorly. It is filled with the cerebrospinal fluid, and this central canal is lined by a single layered cuboidal epithelium, which is called as ependyma. From dorsal fissure, there extends a thin sheet of connective tissue, which is called as dorsal septum, which extends inward. Now the histology of the spinal cord. Spinal cord is formed of two types of matter, gray matter and white matter. Gray matter is internal and it is mainly butterfly shaped in mammals, and in white matter it produced into two horns, which are called as dorsal horns and ventral horns. White matter is external and it is divided into three columns, which are also called as funiculi, and they are the dorsal, lateral and ventral funiculus, which are having nerve tracts in them. And these nerve tracts are of two types, ascending nerve tracts and descending nerve tracts. And function of spinal cord is to control the reflex actions of the body, and it also conducts sensory and motor impulses to and from the brain. Here you can see the diagrams of the spinal cord. This is the diagrammatic representation of the spinal cord, showing the white matter, internal gray matter. These are the two horns, dorsal horn and ventral horn, and these are the fissures. And this is also a diagram showing the histology of the spinal cord, having the central canal in it and various horns. Now the cranial nerves. The nerves which arise directly from the brain and end in the brain are the cranial nerves. These are the specialized nerves, and in amniotes, in rat, 12 pairs of cranial nerves are present, and they are listed according to their number and their functions also. Cranial nerve number 1 is the olfactory nerve, and it is associated with the function of smell. Cranial nerve number 2 is optic nerve, function is vision. Third is oculomotor, and its function is eye movement. Fourth one is the trochlear, it is also associated with the eye movement. Fifth one is the trigeminal, which is having facial sensation. Sixth one is the abducens, eye movement. Seventh, facial expression. Eighth is the vestibulocochlear nerve for hearing and balance. Ninth, glossopharyngeal for oral sensation and taste. 10th is the vagus nerve. And 11th is the accessory cranial nerve for shoulder elevation and head turning. 12th is the hypoglossal for tongue movement. And besides this, one more nerve is present, which is the zero, and which is called as terminal nerve. These are the diagrammatic representation of the cranial nerves. So they are all present in the brain: olfactory, optic, oculomotor, trochlear, abducens, hypoglossal, vagus, facial, all are present inside the brain. Now we will discuss about the sense organs. Sense organs are a group of highly specialized cells which receive the stimuli. They are of two types, basically external receptors and internal receptors. External receptors are mainly organs of touch, taste, smell, sight and hearing, and they are mainly stimulated by the changes in the environment. Internal receptors are for the sensation of fatigue, muscle position, hunger, thirst, sex and pain, etc. And they are stimulated by the stimulus from the body itself. Now we will discuss main sense organs one by one. First of all, we are taking organs of touch. They are also called as tango receptors. The main organs of touch are free nerve endings. They are mainly sensory neurons present in the epithelial layer of the skin mucous membrane and cornea. Merkel's corpuscles, which are also called as tactile discs, and they are the disc-like endings of the nerve fibers in special epithelial cells of human tongue. Basket nerve endings. They are the nerve fibers present around the base of the hair follicles. Meissner's corpuscles. They are present in the dermis and they are most abundant in the palms and soles. Genital corpuscles. They are the nerve endings in the skin of external genitalia and nipples. Pressure receptors located in the deep layers of dermis and subcutaneous tissues. Next is the organs of smell, which are called as olfactoreceptors. Main organ is the nose, and the olfactory part of the nasal chamber is mainly associated with the sense of smell. You can see in this diagram the olfactory organs present at the roof of the nose. This part is sensory and is it made up of olfactory epithelium, which is glandular and columnar, and this olfactory epithelium is also called as Schneiderian membrane. And this is supported by different olfactory cells having the sensory cells and nerve fibers in their endings. Next is the organ of taste, which are also called as gustatory organs. Taste buds are mainly present in the mucosa of the upper surface of tongue, epithelium of the soft palate, pharynx and epiglottis. Now we will discuss the organ of sight, which are also called as photoreceptor, which are a pair of eyes in case of rat. They are located in the orbits on the side of the head. Eye is mainly made up of three coats: fibrous tunic, uvea and retina. Now the fibrous tunic is the tough inelastic membrane complete layer, and it provides the mechanical protection to the eye, and it also provides a space for the attachment of eye muscles and gives shape to the eye. This fibrous tunic is made up of two parts, sclerotic and cornea. Sclerotic is the opaque part of the fibrous tunic and it is formed of white fibrous tissue, and it is also called as white of the eye. Cornea, it is the anterior transparent part of the eye. It is the exposed part and it reflects the light rays to focus on the retina, and it is covered by the conjunctiva. And next is the uvea, which is also called as vascular coat. It is the middle part of the eye and it is formed of three parts: choroid, ciliary part and iridial part. Choroid is the thin part of the eye and it absorbs the extra light and darkens the eyeball and produces nutrition to the retina. Ciliary part is the thickened part of the uvea, and it is less vascular, less pigmented, and it has two types of ciliary muscles in it: circular muscles and meridional muscles. Iridial part is the pigmented part and muscular in nature, and it contains pupil in it. whose structure is regulated by different muscles. Next is the retina, which is the innermost part of the eye, consisting of three parts: optical part, ciliary part, and iridial part. Optical part is thick and pigmented and photosensitive in nature and forms the two-third part of the retina. Contains different photoreceptor and visual cells in it. Ciliary part is thinner pigmented part, contains the ciliary body in it. And iridial part is the thinner pigmented part, and the color of the gives rise to the color of the eye. Here you can see the diagram of the eye. Cornea, pupil, lens, choroid, optic nerves, retina, sclerea, all you can see in this diagram. Two types of visual cells or photoreceptors are present in the eye. They are the rods and cones. Rods contain rhodopsin pigment in them, and they are sensitive to the dim light. Cones, they have the visual pigment iodopsin in them, and they are sensitive to the bright light. Besides this, there is a blind spot present in eye, which is a small area from where optic nerves arise, and this area is without any rods and cones and it is insensitive to light. There is a yellow spot present in the eye, which is a small area, which is the most sensitive to the daylight vision. Lens of rat's eye is solid, circular. You can see in this diagram, lens is present in the eye. It is solid, circular, transparent, and biconvex in nature, and it is present just behind the iris, and it is surrounded by the thin transparent elastic membrane, which is called as lens capsule, and it is suspended in this cavity with the help of suspensory ligaments, and this eye ball is also having two chambers, aqueous chamber and vitreous chamber. Aqueous chamber is the anterior part of the, here you can see the aqueous chamber, here you can see vitreous chamber. So aqueous chamber jo hai, it is a smaller chamber and present between cornea and lens, and it is filled with watery fluid, aqueous humor, which helps in the nutrition to lens and cornea and support the lens, refract the light rays to focus on the retina. And this is the bigger part, which is the vitreous chamber, posterior larger chamber, and it lies between lens and retina and filled with the transparent gelatinous material, vitreous humor, and it provides shape to the eye, supports retina and lens, retracts the light rays, and maintains intraocular pressure. Next is the organs of hearing, which are also called as phonoreceptors, which in case of rat are a pair of ears, and they are located on the lateral side of the head of the rat. Ear is mainly formed of three parts: external ear, middle ear, and internal ear. External ear is consisting of two parts. First part is called as pinna or auricle, which is trumpet shaped in case of rat, having ridges and grooves and supported by elastic cartilages and muscles. And next is the external auditory canal or meatus, which is a tubular canal which runs inwards from concha to the ear drum. It protects the eardrum from direct hitting of hard objects. And besides this, in inner part, there is a tympanic membrane which separates the external ear from the middle ear. It is an oval connective tissue membrane having radiating fibers. Next is the middle ear, which is formed of an irregular air-filled cavity, which is called as tympanic cavity. It is bounded externally by eardrum, that is tympanic membrane, and internally by the auditory capsule. It is enclosed in the bony cavity, which is also called as tympanic bulla. This middle ear cavity is connected by a tubular canal, which is called as Eustachian canal, with the nasopharynx. This Eustachian canal is also called as pharyngotympanic canal. Its pharyngeal opening is mainly guarded by a valve, which is normally remains closed. And its primary function is to keep the air pressure in the tympanic cavity equal on both sides of the eardrums, and it causes free vibrations to the eardrum. Two apertures are present in the middle ear, fenestra ovalis and fenestra rotunda. Besides this, three movable attached bones are present in the middle ear, which are also called as ear ossicles. They are the malleus, incus, and stapes. Here in this diagram, you can see the external ear having the pinna, and this is the middle ear part of the ear having the three ear ossicles, malleus, incus, and stapes. This is the eardrum. Now the internal ear, which is also called as membranous labyrinth. It is also surrounded by the bony part of the auditory capsule, which is called as bony labyrinth. It contains in it a fluid which is called as perilymph. And internal ear is mainly formed of three parts: vestibule, semicircular ducts, and cochlear ducts. Vestibule has two unequal parts in it, utriculus and sacculus. Utriculus is upper part and larger part and having the sensory spot, macula utriculi, in it. Sacculus is the lower smaller part having sensory spot, macula sacculi. And they are both connected by the utriculus and sacculus are both interconnected by a sacculo-utricular duct. Next are the semicircular ducts. They are three in number, mutually perpendicular to one another, and each opens in the utriculus on both the sides. And each duct swells to form an ampulla, which is having a sensory spot, which is called as crista. You can see the semicircular canals in this diagram. Next is the cochlear part. Cochlear duct, it is coiled. You can see here, it is coiled like snail shell and surrounded by the cochlear canal. And it has having scala vestibuli, scala media, and scala tympani in it. The ear performs mainly two functions: hearing and equilibrium. Now, the associated test paper. First of all, very short answer questions. Question number one is, name three meninges of brain. They are pia mater, dura mater and arachnoid membrane. What is arbor vitae? Arbor vitae is the tree like pattern of white matter in the cerebellum. This I have told you in the previous part of the video. What is foramen of Monroe? This I also explained in the part of brain. It is a aperture that connects lateral ventricles of cerebral hemispheres with the third ventricle of diencephalon. How many cranial nerves are present in rat? There are 12 pairs. What are Meissner's corpuscles? Meissner's corpuscles, they are present, they are mainly associated with the sense of touch in case of rat, and they are present in the dermis, and they are most abundant in palms and soles. What is terminal nerve? It is a zero nerve, a fine nerve present in the case of rat that arises from the mucous membrane of the nasal sac and joins the forebrain, and it is the somatic sensory nerve. Question number 7 is, what is blind spot? Blind spot is present in the eye, and this is the small area where optic nerves arise, and it is without rods and cones, so it is insensitive to light. Next are the short answer questions. Question number 1 is, write a short note on spinal cord of rat. Question number 2 is, write about the cranial nerves of rat. Question number 3 is, write a note on internal ear of rat. Number 4 is, draw a label diagram of sagittal section of the brain of rat. Next are the long answer questions. Question number 1 is, give a detailed account of rat's brain. Question number 2 is, explain the structure of eye of rat. And question number 3 is, write a brief account of structure of the ear of rat. Thank you.